Hello friends, in this video we are going to discuss a case Abdul Aziz versus Masum Ali. This case is related to lawful consideration. So let's first understand under which subject, topic and subtopic this case can be mentioned. So the subject is law of contract. The topic is characteristics of a contract. And the subtopic is lawful consideration. Now we will understand the facts of the case. So in this case, Abdul Aziz versus Masum Ali, the defendant promised to the plaintiff to donate money for rebuilding a mosque, but he failed to pay the amount later. So basically there was some defendant, he might be some familiar person or friend or somebody to plaintiff, and the plaintiff wanted to rebuild a mosque, and the defendant promised that okay fine, I'll give you money and you can rebuild it, but later for some reason he could not pay the amount. So the plaintiff might have gone to the court and filed a case. Let's understand the judgment. So in this case, since there was nothing in return, so it was not a valid consideration. So basically, here defendant promised to donate money for rebuilding the mosque, but there was nothing in return. Defendant was not getting anything from plaintiff. So there was no lawful consideration. In that case, it was held that the contract was void. So here we are seeing an example when only from one side something has been promised to give something, but from other side there is nothing returned. So in this case, there is no lawful consideration. So the contract is void. We will also understand a little bit about lawful consideration. Every contract must be supported by a lawful consideration. Consideration means something in return. Okay, let's say A and B are making a contract. So A and B both have to give something to each other. In that case, only contract is valid. For existence of consideration, both the parties to the contract must have some gain and some loss. Okay, let me give you another example. Suppose, let's say, I tell my friend that I will give you 100 rupees. And you just do some of my work. Okay, let's say I ask him to carry something from my house to somewhere else for my need. So in this case, he is getting 100 rupees. In return, I am getting one work done by him. So in this case, there is lawful consideration. If one party always gains and another party always loses, then there is no consideration at all. One more thing, the lawful consideration does not mean that it has to be always in cash. The consideration may be in the present or in the past or in the future. Consideration must be real and lawful, and it should not be vague. And if the consideration is unlawful, then the contract is void. I hope this video was helpful. Please subscribe and like the video. I will be very soon uploading another video. Thank you so much.